where the spies fly sky high. In today's episode, we'll be snooping around a company that supposedly faces some problems, despite the fact that on the outside, it seems to be doing well. Apparently, the employees are actually becoming increasingly disgruntled. It is our job here today at SPYTV to piece together a story for the public to see. Our reporter, Tan Ah Kau, is at the scene right now, ready to bring you closer to where the action is.
Hi, I'm on site outside XXX Company, ready to bring you up close and personal. Are you ready? Okay, let's go.
Okay, I'm outside. Attention to the company now. Let's try to keep it down.
Right time, we were just looking for you.
What's wrong? Does this have anything to do with the fight last week in
the
pantry?
I'm really unhappy about recent changes in policy of OT hour.
In the past, I can make more than 3,000 a month. But now, I can only make 2,400 a month. And I blame all this because of this contract employee over here, who isn't even Singaporean.
What the 400? I made overwork myself, you know? And my pay is only 6 bucks per hour. And what kind of nonsense is this? I get fed only a little, why have to work more? I should be paid more and more, you know?
That is none of my business. All I want is to get more OT hour, so that I can get more money back to my family and I. You better quit, or else.
Calm down, boys. Relax. This is just a new company policy. We don't have a choice either. We need to cut costs due to the recent economic downturn. Please understand that I don't have a choice either. Besides, cutting down on the number of OT hours is not a big deal.
Not a big deal? You know, I think us, the contract employees, are being exploited.
I understand that you don't bring in as much money as you did before. And you, I understand that you don't earn as much as he does. But you have to understand there's nothing much I can do about this.
Oh yeah, but still, you know, you make use of us during the weekdays and you force us to stay back and to work more without higher pace. But later, you don't let us come back to work on the weekends. How come, huh? I know already, I know you don't want to pay us 1.5 times more. And that's not bad enough, right? I cannot have the same benefits as him. These permanent employees, my work pass is different from him also. I cannot access certain areas like him. Then, when I take the bus, right? I have to alight so far from the workplace and have to walk to the workplace. Just like him, huh? He just sat the bus all the way up to this blood difference entrance. What a nonsense.
Oh, yo, whatever lah, ho. My problem is of greater concern here. I've been working here for so many years, and this is how you treat us, permanent employee. You don't simply make changes in policy and make it seem like just a small change, you know. We, permanent employee, feel that you are hiring more and more contract employee. Do you have any idea that we feel threatened by their presence, you know? Half of us do not even feel motivated to work here anymore. The company next door, ABC Company, just pay more than you do, huh? And I bet one thing, you don't even know that some of them are even playing the tower there. They feel that they can get retrenched anytime soon, so they can just slack it off.
You think only you feel unmotivated, huh? I feel even worse, huh? You know, us, the contract employees, exploited.
Hey, wait a minute. I think you didn't even put in effort to make the announcement clear. You never tell us why there's a sudden change in policy. Yeah, we know recently there's an economic downturn and the company needs to save costs. But at least you could have done is to tell us proper details and warnings in advance. But you are not. You didn't even take into account our feeling, you know, and our opinion.
Oh yeah, at this part I agree with him. For us, right, for the contract employee, we don't have information properly either. And you know, when I wanted to do OT work, right, you know what I ended up with? I ended up with gotten nothing. I working for you. I work for free. Because I didn't feel in this firm, and nobody told me anything about this new OT firm. Why, huh?
What do I do to solve this problem of inequality and motivation?
Wow, that was explosive. Let's find out more from our roving reporter, Akau, who is live at the scene.
Wow, Akau, what do you make of the current situation?
Okay, firstly, the change in policy with regards to OT hours envelops everyone, contract and permanent staff alike. It has incited different reactions, but the general unhappiness can be felt throughout strongly.
What actually caused this wave of dissatisfaction amongst the employees?
Employees were not involved in the decision-making process, neither were they given ample time to prepare for this change. This seriously violates the structural determinants of procedural justice, which states that people better accept organizational decisions to the extent that they have a say in them. And furthermore, both groups felt that the officials treated them in a distant and uncaring manner while announcing this policy change. This demonstrates a severe lack of social sensitivity.
I see. Is there anything else amiss?
The permanent staff grapple with the lack of motivation in doing their job. Presently, they are already outnumbered by contract employees 3-1. It seems to them that the company has greater intentions of hiring even more contract workers, as it is economically in their best interest. The permanent staff feel that eventually they will lose their place in this company to the more inexpensive labour, which is the contract employees. A possible explanation to this would be that their most basic need of belongingness is not met. The permanent staff feel that their position in the company is not secure because the company is hiring more contract workers as their cheaper labour. They feel as if they do not belong and might easily be asked to leave anytime soon. Their esteem is pushed way down because of this.
What about the contract workers? Do they have such problems too?
Well, not exactly. Their problem is of different nature. The thing is that they do the same work for a much lesser pay. Thus, the contract staff feel exploited to a certain extent. In addition, they don't enjoy the same benefits which the permanent staff get. Equity theory states that workers that are driven by a desire to be treated fairly, and if workers perceive they're receiving fair treatment, they will be more driven to work. While on the other hand, if there is unequal treatment, they will try to take measures to reduce this inequity. In the case of the contract employees, they were comparing themselves to the permanent staff. Their input, which is the work they do, are similar. However, their outputs vary distinctly. Namely, the salary and the benefits which they enjoy from the company. Well, that is all I see of the situation so far. Back to you.
Now that we've shed light on the problems, it is our task here at the studio to attempt to solve them. We have with us here today, Ms. Lo, an expert on management and organization, to give us her insights. So, Ms. Lo, how do we go about solving the issue at hand?
The first thing the management should do is make sure that the employees are well informed. Since one of their complaints is that they were kept in the dark about the new policy, what they can do now is chair a proper meeting whereby employees gather to be briefed in detail on the policy change. This is so that everyone knows what the change is and why it needs to happen. During the meeting, the management should admit that it was a blunder on their part in not disseminating information properly. In the meeting, everyone should be given the autonomy to speak up. Most importantly, however, employees should be given ample time to adapt to the change in policy. Perhaps starting on a clean slate with a settling time of 1 week will be suitable for them to adapt sufficiently.
So that solves the problems brought about by the sudden change in OT work policy. But what about the issue of the unmotivated permanent staff then?
It seems like the permanent employees struggle with the fear of being replaced by the more inexpensive contract workers. Their hopes of a stable future with the company have been dashed by such thoughts. To lessen their insecurities, the management must attempt to cultivate a greater sense of belonging for them in the company. They can do this in a few ways. They can increase frequency of feedback surveys to make the permanent employees feel that their opinions are valued and that the management genuinely cares about their well-being. Human beings, they have an innate need to be in control. The permanent staff should be given more flexibility with respect to how they choose to do their work, as long as they don't underperform. This will make them feel less stifled and hopefully encourage a more pleasant working environment. Other suggestions can include proposing bonds that offer job security, or provide more opportunities for promotions and similar incentives. And you can also level the ratio of contract to permanent workers so that they don't feel so threatened by the stark difference in numbers.
I see. But on to the contract employees now. How can we help them?
Contract employees, they deal with the problem of perceived inequality. It is indeed a fact that not much can be done on the company's part to change the pay. Thus, what they can do is change the contract employees' feelings about this perceived inequality. They can do this by allowing them to enjoy the same benefits as permanent employees, such as entrances to the company, which is apparently of great importance to them. However, this would only take place after their evaluative trial period is over. If their performance is good, they'll get to enjoy these benefits, and perhaps even be able to become permanent employees.
That sounds great. Thank you, Ms. Lo. We've come to the end of the show. Thank you for watching, and see you next semester.